just to not interrupt, as you might be able to hear, we have students studying, we have people reading, enjoying just gentle page flipping, the soothing effect of being in a library or a bookstore can help people relax, or you might even find some dozing off in our big comfortable chairs, maybe next to the fireplace, or next to the lamps. For young audiences, they're playful and colorful. This one. And it goes through the alphabet. And it tells a silly story of all the different alphabet letters climbing up into the coconut tree, but then, uh-oh, they all fall down. You get into a big pile. And they have all of their parents, the uppercase letters, coming to save the lowercase letters. Have little things. I wrote the book. It's cute and fun to read, especially for the kids. Could they rhyme with everything? So it's very cute. And by the end of the book, says at the very end, but chicka, boom, boom, look, there's a full moon. He is out of bed, and this is what he said. Dare, double dare, you can't catch me. I'll beat you to the top of the coconut tree. Chicka, boom, boom. Just a fun book. You can read to your kids or grandkids or have the kids read it to themselves. So it's a fun, colorful, as you can tell, with the pink and the polka dots. So we'll put this one up to the side. wake up in the morning. You can tell their children that all of the animals are sleepy. But this one's curled up behind the tree sleeping in a pile of leaves. This one's yawning. Peekaboo, sleepy hedgehog. Yawn and curl into a spiky ball. And it goes on and each time it shows you a new one, a new character, a new creature. Peekaboo. Tired bears snuggle and snooze in your cozy case. See, and you can tell them that they're sleeping, or they're cuddling. And you can show them that it's bedtime. Shooting stars glitter and glow in the midnight sky. Peekaboo. You can be silly with it and count the stars, the shooting stars. 1, 2, 3. And you can see the back of the characters that are already in the book so far. Wise owls, hoot and swoop from your treetop home. Peekaboo. Look, there's our friends already. They're sleeping. Bright moon, shimmer and shine on the sleepy world. Good night. And the big bright moon, smiling, watching over all the animals until morning. This one's a good book for kids, trying to get them to go to bed. You can count certain things like after Zeus was able to bring them out in really unique and special ways. And you can add voices to your characters if you're reading them to your kids, or just kids in general, and make them sound funny or annoyed. Whatever you feel like doing, that's up to you. Books are a great way to expand the minds of children and adults. I'm gonna flip. Upset with Sam, because Sam keeps asking him if he wants green eggs and ham in different situations like this. You may like them, you will see. You may like them in a dream. And you can see his face. By the end, he likes them. I do so like green eggs and ham. Thank you, Sam. I am. So, a really cute Dr. Seuss book, a fun read. Kids, or if you want to read it yourself, it's just a funny book. And this one, another Dr. Seuss book. By Dr. Seuss. One fish. Have silly rhymes and silly things. And fun pictures to look at. And you can be silly with your kids. You just say, what's a zan? And that is why we have a Zans. A Zans for kids is very good. Have you a Zans for kids? You should. You can laugh and be silly with them. And like I said, you can add voices. Sing. You just have a fun way of telling stories and being silly with it. To make it where the kids want to read. The other Dr. Seuss book. So, two more books that I think your kids or you yourself would like are just fun books. few more books to go through. These are greatly illustrated books. A Year in Bramley Hedge by Jill. Horror stories throughout the seasons. Place. They live in a hedge grove, telling stories of what it's like. Cute little pictures of the mice and their dresses or their suits. Colored. Greatly illustrated books. So much attention to detail. Even with the little teacups hanging on the shelf, and there's more that are missing. They're probably dirty in the sink somewhere. And look. Yummy cakes, pies, desserts. It makes you want to go there and try some. And now you come to why they're making all those. They have a big spring picnic. Through summer, you can tell it's hot because they're on the shade and their tails are in the water. It's a summer book. mulberries. Other times, giant mushrooms. Just a very cute, loving story. Reminds me of Christmas. You want to curl up on your couch with a nice cup of hot chocolate and a blanket wrapped snugly around you, tucked in tight. And they're digging tunnels underneath the snow. Set of books. I don't know if anybody knows his symbol. J-R-R-T. J-R-R Tolkien. The Hobbit. Thank you. fiddler. And it goes through the hobbit. And now Bilbo finds the ring. A few pictures, but mostly just words. Mirkwood. But Legolas Greenleaf resides and grow up. The elf. Such an amazing imagination. And all of them are different colors. All embossed. Of the ring. So for those who really like fantasy, magic, adventure, these books are very fun. You get lost inside of them. That's the beauty of good books. As you can tell, you have a lot to choose from. From young kids to a little bit older, with pictures, funny stories, to these books, very picturesque. Two, three, four, coffee bar if you'd like to get a warm beverage, or if you want iced tea or soda, whatever you'd like, we have over there. We have some danishes and some cookies and cupcakes. So again, you can spend all day here curled up with a good book or just listening to page flipping. Even honestly, you can take a nap. I know a lot of our customers do because it's so relaxing in here. So again, I hope you have a good day, and we will see you next time.